You know, before I gave my life to Christ, I was living for this world just like anybody else. So here's a little bit of my testimony. Check it out.
Growing up 14, living on the east side. I never claimed 14, I used to claim that what seaside. Wanna be a gangster, cause that's just what you do. I was trying to gain a rep by hanging with a crew. Grew up in a good home, but still felt lost. I tried to fit in anywhere, no matter what it cost. As the oldest brother, I was trying to paint a picture. Mexican descent with a Filipino mixture. Didn't have a role model, someone to look up to. Did my own things, and I made up my own rules. Hanging with the homeboys, getting high in the backyard. Drinking 40s on the corner, trying to look real hard. And my ignorance got worse as I was growing older. By the time I was a senior, yo, my ignorance got bolder. Doing dumb stuff and never getting caught. Till I slipped one day and got caught on the spot. Sitting nervous in that cell, feeling like a fool. Handcuffs hurt my wrist, but I was trying to play it cool. Only 18 and I'm in this situation. I was looking at 15, forget graduation. That's the first time that I called out his name. Nowhere else to turn in this life full of shame. I said, God, if you're real, then please help me out. If you get me out of this mess, I'll live for you, no doubt. A couple hours later, I was set free. They took me out the cell and they let me on the street. Didn't know how it happened and didn't ask no questions. It must have been the favor of the name that I mentioned.
Jesus. You are my child and I love you very much. I'll always have your back even though you mess up. I have plans for your life, so won't you give me your heart? I can give you new identity and a new start. I know that you are young and only 18, but do you really want this world or do you want me? Now it's up to you, I know you hear my voice. The decision is yours, go ahead and make your
whatever
choice.
Whatever you want.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't you know God will provide?
He provided for me.
Need.
He got me out
call
that jail cell, you know.
And he'll supply.
I just call
whatever
on his name.
Want.
Next thing you know, I'm on the street.
Don't you know God will provide?
That was the first miracle that ever happened in my life.
Call out his name.
You just gotta call out his
supply.
Name. He's real.
2 years later, still haven't learned my lesson. Trying to be a player, going in the wrong direction. Till my girl got pregnant, now what am I to do? Do I step up like a man, or be that other dude? So I called on the name that I called on before, and hoped that he would hear me and come knocking at my door. That night I prayed hard and prepared to go to bed. And when I fell asleep, he woke me up and he said,
remember the first time you called on my name? You said that you would live for me and quit playing games. I gave you some time, but you messed up again. This time it's gonna cost you. Give up all your friends.
What?
Marry that girl and go and make her your wife.
Right.
Find a good church and you'll have a blessed life. But never look back and always look to me. It'll cost you a lot, but I will set you free.
Whatever you want.
That's when I fully gave my life to Christ.
God will provide.
Second time around, I wasn't playing
call
no more games. I had to give up all my friends. Start fresh. Started going to church. Started reading my word, you know. Yeah, that's right. 20 years later, here I am today. Still living for Christ. I got a blessed life. I got a blessed wife. Blessed family. Raised my kids in church. They have a relationship with Christ. Ever since then, things have just changed for me. And it can happen for you too, you know? You just gotta trust and believe. You gotta ask Christ in your life. Now my oldest daughter's going to college. God has just blessed us through and through. Been married 18 years, no divorce, you know what I'm saying? God is real, He can change your life. You just gotta call out His name. Thank you, Jesus.